machine design myself, Naimisha Goswami. In this lecture, we start material handling equipment. So, we understand basic fundamental of requirement of material handling system, material handling equipment. What are the objective of material handling system? What are the principles of material handling system? What is material handling system and how many types of material handling system will be used? So, that we will cover in today's lecture. Okay. So, first of all, what is material handling? What is known as material handling? And what is the requirement? So we know when we have to move material from one place to another place, we require some equipment to transfer that material, right? So that is known as your type of equipment is known as your material handling equipments, right? So when we will apply our scientific knowledge or some mathematical consideration, or we apply some mechanical fundamental or apply science in packing and storing of subject in any room, or to packing and movement of your lot size or some material from one place to another place, so that is known as your material handling system. Okay, now what are the importance of material handling system? So what are the importance? So first of all, it is used in function of production control, because in production control we have to supply raw inventory, we have to take out a finished product or in process inventory, we have to manage. All time management is very, very important in production control. Okay, so that is first point. And second point is, it is also very important with your scheduling. Okay, so scheduling, what is mean by your scheduling? So scheduling is a time management system. When you have when you have to supply material, when you have to pick up your material, when you have to dispatch the materials, so it is all related with your time. Okay, so that is known as scheduling, right? Next is your material handling at value to product cost. When we will do all process on time, so ultimately our cost will be reduced. Okay, so that is also important, and it is also used to increase effectiveness in plant layout by reducing the cost. Okay, so our in material handling system or any type of industry, it is important to reduce your cost, increase your productivity and reduce your wastage, so that is, and reduce your money also. So these are very important point. So these all are importance of your material handling equipment. Now what are the objective? So objective of material handling system are, we have already discussed importance. So importance is also directly related with your objective of material handling system. Okay, so first of all, it is used to lower your unit material handling cost. Okay, so when we will do all thing on time, wastage will be reduced. Because if there is not more movement will be there in industry, you will produce layout, either product layout or either process layout. Okay, in such process, the material should move as minimum distance. That is our motive, or that is our objective also. Okay, so it will, so that's directly reduce your material handling cost and also reduce your manufacturing cycle with respect to your time. Okay, and when we will do all process on time, we will supply material on time, we will pick material time, we will dispatch material on time, so all inventory movement will be on time, so it also control your flow of materials. Okay, and it is also used to provide better working conditions, and it is also it also contribute for better quality by avoiding damages to product. Okay, so when damages of product, when all cycle or all material movement will be on time, okay, so there you can also reduce your damages, so it will also increase your productivity. Okay, and it also increase your storage capacity through better utilization of storage area. When you will plan better in a proper manner, so you can use proper area, right? Or you can say that storage area. So these are your objective of material handling system. Okay, so ultimately it will reduce your manufacturing cost, because all these points are totally depend on your manufacturing cost. So these are directly related with your manufacturing cost. So it will ultimately reduce your manufacturing cost. Now, what are the principles of material handling system? Okay. So first step was your importance of material handling system. Second is your objective of material handling system, and third is your principle. So what we have discussed in objective and importance of material handling system. So these are directly made your principle. Okay, or we can say that these are principle of material handling system. Okay. So material movement should be little as much as possible. So I have already explained this point. Okay, movement should be reduced. Okay, plant layout or process layout should be is like that. Okay, material have to move as minimum distance. Okay, so by reducing the time by using shortest routes by mechanical equipment. Okay. When we use mechanical equipment, either these are power governed or either these are manually operated. So ultimately we will reduce your time. Okay. And next point is movement of material should be in lot size. These are not individual unit. Okay. If there is one lot, so we will not, if there is single unit, so we will not prefer just to move that unit, right? We will prepare several unit and we will make one lot and then we will move that material. Okay, and that's lot size. Okay, so it will save your time. Okay, ultimately it will also save your fuel. So ultimately it will save or it will increase your manufacturing productivity or it will reduce your manufacturing cost, because each and every cost is included in final product. So ultimately that will be reduced, right? And design of material handling equipment should be such that it can increase your effectiveness of your system. Okay, so that should not complex, that should be compact. Okay, it should not complex. The material will be here to there, right? It should be in flow 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. So that process should be like that. Okay, and rehandling of material should be also avoided, right? And we have to check or repair, maintain material handling equipments on time to time, right? So that point is also very important. So these all are your principles of material handling system. Now, what are the factors which affect your material handling system? So there are basic three factors which affect your selection of material handling equipment. How to select your material handling system? So first factor is your here. First is here, production problem. So what is production problem? Generally, we will give your project or you will do project in several industry. You have to find out one problem. From that industry, then you have to solve it by using your product layout, process layout, and different changes by reduction of time or by increasing of your productivity. So we will do that type of project many times, right? Okay. So, and second factor is human element involvement, and third is your capabilities of handling equipments available. Okay, so what is which type of material you have to handle? So on basis of that we will use that equipment. So these are the very important three factor on which selection of material handling equipments are depends. Okay, so what are the types of material handling equipments are available? So first is your manually operated equipments, or you can say that there is powered operated and non power operated. Okay, power means where we supply some input electricity or any by battery moving is like that. Okay, so if these are manually operated, so there is no power is required. Okay, and some systems or material handling equipments are like that, which are operated by your power, or we have to supply some input electricity or whatever. Okay, and so second is your conveyors. So these are power operated. Industrial trucks, tractors, trailers, cranes and hoists, and AGV. AGV is your automated guided vehicles. So these are the different types of equipments which are generally used in material handling system. So we will do study one by one. Okay, so first is your manually operated equipment, or you can say that non-powered. Okay, so it is also handwheel barrow. So handwheel barrow, you can see here, these are used to movement of material within a store or shop. These are not used outside of your storage. These are used in store or shop. Okay, it is used by two or more workers by carrying load. Okay, so a small load you can transfer in shop floor. So by using this, you can transfer that load inside of your shop. Second is your hand trolley. So hand trolley is consist of your metal structure supported on three or four wheels. They are either open type or closed type. Okay, sorry. So you can see here, these are wheels are used, two wheeler, or you can say that four wheels are used, or these are operated like this. You can better understand by your here.